Now, I said I wasn't going to do any Halloween videos after the other one. But I guess I was wrong. Now, we found another solution to our problems of recording. I can't show you because I've just been stupid. Tell me this isn't the world's biggest banana you've ever seen. Look at this. Come on. I mean, if I brought another banana and measured it to this one, you'd see what I mean. I'm not gonna do that. Today, eight true Halloween horror stories to make your skin crawl. Now, I think I'm gonna take the mask off because I can hardly see in this thing. So we can have a bit of fun stories. And this is from Mr. Nightmare, guy who has better stories than the other dude. Lego. Happy Halloween, everyone.
I was 22 years old.
Oh, by the way, the other Halloween film video that we did was filmed like a week ago, so we were prepared for it. In case my mom got sick or anything. So that's why it's different clothing than that, so just let you know.
Attending a Halloween party at my former best friend Nick's house, who died of a heroin overdose in 2013. Before his death, he would throw big Halloween parties every year at his house, as his parents routinely flew to New York every year to attend their own friend's party. He was always a big Halloween freak, so the whole house was littered with truly horrifying props that we all knew Nick spent way too much money on. He even
built
giant walls of cardboard and covered them with wallpapers to create a haunted maze of sorts. I want to keep this story PG-13 rated, so I'll skip the weed, beer, LSD, and sex, and get right to the part where...
Weed, beer...
things got bad. I'll admit, we weren't in our right minds. None of us were. Anyone who came to Nick's parties knew what went down. Me, Nick, and a few other guys, Vinny G, Joey, and Q, were upstairs in Nick's room smoking a bong when we heard two steady, loud bangs come from downstairs. Nick clumsily but panickingly rushed to open the door and see what was going on. There were sounds of screaming of both guys and girls. I remember quite clearly it sounded as if there were a crowd of people screaming for their lives down there. We all called Nick to come back in and shut the door. Even under the influence of drugs, we all knew what was going on. He ran back inside and shut the door quickly but also quietly, locking it behind him.
Man, I would too.
Turned to us, had on the facial expression of someone who had just witnessed murder. What did you see? What's going on? We all shouted at him. He told us to hide before anything else. We all knew why. From that point on, we didn't ask questions. Nick hit the lights and hid in the closet with Joey, while I hid under the bed with Q, and Vinny G hid in the storage box. We could hear the blasting music from downstairs turn off, followed by a grown man screaming at everyone to shut up. One unfortunate girl let out a scream of shock and fear, and after another bang.
No. You messed up. If you hear someone in the house, don't go, ah! Just to make it official that you're still in the house and alive. You don't do that. I would have if I saw he or she doing, about to scream, I would have gone, no. No, no. Shh.
Silence. The man started shouting at everyone again, but personally I couldn't hear it too well, and I certainly as hell wouldn't remember exactly what he was shouting. We heard two other men shouting. By now there were a confirmed three intruders in the house, but there could have been more for all we knew at that point.
Never mind.
I heard the sound of boots stomping up the stairs and then coming halfway down the hall and stopping outside the door. The intruder on the other side of the door tried the doorknob, but when he...
I don't know if you heard that, but this would have sounded like... I don't know if you could hear that, but...
Realized it was locked. He started ramming into the door with most likely his shoulder. After he failed attempts at...
I'd jump out the window. Just to be clear. Yeah, that... I'd look outside my house. This is like a little roof, yeah? I can just jump on out the window, onto that ledge, bless you, and go onto the grass and run. Yes, it is from Dashi. I'm just doing it.
To that, the sound of a few shots to the doorknob were clearly enough to break the lock, allowing the door to swing open. We heard cries from downstairs after the shots to the doorknob, followed by silence and gunshot. Me and Nick had our hands on our mouths to shield our breathing noises. I watched through the transparent cloth that hung from the bottom of Nick's bed.
Just by the way, if I hear some banging noise downstairs, I'd either A, drag my friends out with me to go the hell out, or B, bye, you're on your own. Yay!
As the black boots with overlapping ripping denim jeans moved instinctively to the closet, he opened the door. I could hear Nick begging for the intruder not to kill him, offering a generous amount of money if they would leave. Nick gave himself up as the house owner. That's when the intruder ordered him downstairs. The rest of us stayed put. Apparently, Joey hadn't been caught with Nick.
Saint Nick?
Shaking and afraid.
Get it? Saint Nick? Santa Claus? No, this just leaves the Christmas puns in December. We don't need this.
There was near silence from downstairs, other than Nick talking with the intruders, but whatever they were saying was much too low for us to hear. It felt like a mere 20 minutes before the front door slammed shut. Nick came running back upstairs to tell us that they were gone. I think the most horrifying moment of my life was when I stepped downstairs back into the living room and saw the two dead bodies laying lifelessly on the ground.
Hell no. You ain't my friend no more. You brought me to your house for a party. You nearly got us killed and his dead bodies in your living room, or wherever he said it is. We ain't friends anymore. I ain't coming to your house. You would be on the haunted wanted list for that. What the hell? Yes. I just want to make sure of something. Okay. Just making sure that the store recording, because I can't see the head from it.
Holes in their heads spewing out blood. Jen and Robbie. Two good friends that I still miss. I'll spare you the details of what happened when the police arrived, but...
Police! Police! There's dead people in here! Hurry! I really want to eat this on camera, but I was told by a certain friend that eating stuff while in a video distracts you from the video, so you can just either stare at it or listen to the video. Just put a smile on that. One of these days, my pun's gonna get worse than Yang's. Fine. Sad face. I should literally get an app and animate it.
Despite the fact that the house smelled like a marijuana greenhouse, the police were more interested in finding out who the masked men were that killed two innocent college students. Oh yeah, Nikki told the four of us who were hiding in his room that there were four intruders in total, all wearing fedoras, vendetta masks, coats and gloves.
I thought you said there was three.
They demanded $100,000 in cash, and when Nick could not provide it, they demanded he fill their empty sack with his most valued possessions.
Here you go. Yeah. Get off my house. There, you can have everything. Just get out the house. There, I've packed everything. Goodbye, you can go now.
All the partygoers held hostage in the room were also forced to throw their wallets into the sack or they would be shot.
No.
After the incident, Nick became depressed. He started drinking too much, becoming an alcoholic. He stopped showing up to school, ultimately ended up dropping out. He started the use of heavier drugs, such as meth and heroin.
Of course you would.
I had one good talk with him since the incident, and he was more real during this talk than he had ever been. He told me, with tears rolling down his cheeks and a pipe in his hand, he lived in constant pain, knowing he caused the death of two of his best friends. Nick died of a heroin overdose in July of 2013, even a year after the incident.
This is good. Man, number one story? I was legit. It's either beat the crap out of the intruders if they have guns, or I'll just give them everything I own. I don't care. I have a lot of money, I can just go ahead and get more. Yeah. You can have the banana. No? No, Jerry, it's not for you. Number two.
My first Halloween to leave my own house away from my parents. I live in a small corner house with a basement but no upstairs, a house my parents paid half for. It was 11 o'clock at night, and I was sitting in the living room watching scary Halloween movies when I found myself getting up to answer a knock at the door.
Speaking of which, I stopped watching Nightmare Before Christmas, one of my favorite Halloween movies to watch on Halloween, so I could do this video for y'all.
I stopped and thought, who could be at the door at 11 p.m.?
Burglars?
Surely there were no more trick-or-treaters out.
Killers?
I had a pretty good feeling it was a late-night Halloween ding-dong ditcher, so I gave it a second, and I shot a glance to the porch through the window. They were gone already. Yup, ding-dong ditchers.
Yep. Tigsy?
I sat back down, not...
No, Tiggs, no.
Thinking twice about it, and again, knocking at the front door. Get lost, I yelled. I was not in the mood for punky kids. They ignored my demands and started pounding now, not just knocking. I was pissed now. I leaped up and swung the door open. And one was there once again. I slipped on my shoes and headed outside to begin searching the bushes for the kids. But there was nobody in sight.
Ghosts,
not the bushes,
killers, burglars.
Not my car, out across the street. I was done.
Can you still see me?
I didn't want to feed into their fun anymore, so I went back inside, double locked the door, and went to my bedroom, also locking that door, just to feel safer, I guess. Even over the TV, I could still hear the stupid kids pounding on my front door repeatedly. So close to calling the cops to get them away.
So close. Ah! I'd call them right away. They'll get the kids out of my way. I don't know. Oh, that's kids, if you can do that too. But you know what I mean. I just call them.
That would undoubtedly lead to my house being named or TP. How do continue for an uncomfortably long time? What?
I don't know if y'all can hear that, but there's like a... plane or helicopter. I don't know if y'all could hear that, but that was a helicopter flying past us. That hardly happens while recording.
Within half an hour, I thought these kids must be filming something for YouTube and were desperate for a reaction, but I wasn't going to give it to them. At some point, I dozed off with the TV on, only to wake up to the knocking again.
Now how bad of a person I'd be, someone doing this, find out it's YouTube video, go, help me. I'd make them scared, so scared if they were kids actually, I'd make them so scared they'd just start running.
It's 2 in the fucking morning, how could those kids still be at it?
It's not kids.
I turned the TV off and sat up with my ears open.
The kids must... the actual kids must probably be asleep after getting all that much candy.
For a few moments, my heart completely stopped as I realized the knocking was not at my front door, but rather at my bedroom door.
Hell no.
I jumped out of bed, looking around my room like a madman for something to use as a weapon. They knew I was awake now. They were trying the doorknob, trying to buzz down the door. These weren't any kids. By some miracle, I came up with an idea. It was a long shot, but it was all I could think of.
What is it?
I turned on the receiver to my speaker system, plugged in my iPhone, brought up the YouTube app, typed in 45 gunshot sound effect, turned on the volume.
He's going home alone on everyone. I'll get every 3-10 seconds, get your ugly, yellow, no good keys to off my property. You all know that scene? Get it? And then 1, 2, 10.
Pressed play. The sound of the gunshot echoed out of the speakers. It sounded real enough. I paused the video after the first shot and yelled, "That was a warning shot. Leave now or I won't hesitate to shoot you in the head." And it worked. I heard 2 pairs of footsteps stomping over my wood floors and out the front door. I gave it a moment before opening my bedroom door and peeking outside. They were gone, but the front door was left wide open. I quickly shut it, called the police, and that's where my story ended.
Number 3. I don't know if I was allowed to say all that stuff with the quotes in it, but if I wasn't, I'm my bad, I didn't know. it's capable.
So I was never really a big Halloween.
Yeah, who are you?
Person. Mostly because I grew up without many friends, and once I passed the age of 10, I couldn't use the excuse of going with my mom anymore.
Is that Mr. Nightmare, or who is that?
And it's not like I have friends to go with.
Dang, Mr. Nightmare.
So this last Halloween, I was 14 years old. I do have a little sister who's...
I will just clean my mask.
So my mom went trick-or-treating with her. My one really good friend, Steve, already had plans and I didn't want to impose. So it didn't seem like I'd be trick-or-treating this year. I felt a tiny part of me explode with happiness on the inside when my mom asked me to stay home and hand out candies. Now I felt like I had a job to do that didn't involve me trick-or-treating alone like a loser. My mom left with my sister at about 6 o'clock, about an hour after she got home from work. She told me to expect her back around 9. So I was relaxing on the couch in the living room, watching the scary movie marathon on AMC, and occasionally answering the door to give candy to the kids. And while doing that, the kitchen phone began to ring. I remember the ringer was set so loud it actually made me jump. I picked up the phone, and the other end remained silent, except for a bit of fumbling in the background. Sounds you'd expect when somebody's holding a phone.
I'll stop.
I think I said hello about 5 times before the person on the other end hung up. I just knew it was somebody pulling a Halloween prank call on me.
I wouldn't think
that. What else did I do but ignore it? That worked well enough for the next few minutes, watching TV, answering the phone, until the phone rang again. Same unknown number coming up on the caller ID. I wanted to see where this was going. So I picked it up once more. This time I could hear a very faint breathing on the other end. All right, Steve, I know it's you, I said into the phone. They hung up.
You just told him your friend's name. He's gonna go he's gonna go after him now.
By this point, I didn't want to say I was scared, but I was for sure a bit uneasy. It was a long time before that phone rang again. It was getting later, darker, and the doorbell seemed to be ringing less and less. I was watching the original Friday the 13th when it happened again. The sound of that thump.
Speaking of which, I'm watching Freddy vs. Jason tonight.
The ringing had become sickening, as I knew who it would be, or rather, I didn't. For some reason, I gave in again and picked up. And once again, silence. Other than the faint breathing and fumbling of the phone. It was like this for almost half a minute before they finally spoke in an exaggerated deep voice.
I'll be paying you a visit tonight.
Hell no.
I had enough of this joke.
I barricaded all my windows and doors. Hell no.
I told them to fuck off and hang up the phone, promising to myself not to pick it up again.
I wouldn't answer it on the third time.
I'd say about half an hour later, out of the blue, all the power in the house was cut.
Boom.
The lights went out. The TV turned off.
Hell no. Nope.
I stood up and frozen in fear.
Also just found out it says, featuring Mr. Creepypasta, so this is probably who it is.
When loud and angry thumping came from the front door, I completely lost it and began screaming like a girl, but there was something coming from outside. Laughter. I recognized that laughter. I opened the door and there he was. Stephen.
Of course.
I shoved him nearly down the steps out of anger. So, that was you who made those dumb phone calls, I asked.
I don't think if the dude's reading the phone
like
story
or not. Let me hear you do that voice again, I said. What? He seemed confused. I didn't say anything, you idiot. I just called and did that heavy breathing. I thought he was lying at first. But then my heart dropped.
Is the battery okay?
Follow me to the fuse box outside. Just as I feared, it had been opened and all the wires had been snipped.
yeah, no crap.
Faster than any Olympic champions back into the house. I called my mom, who told us to stay inside and wait for the police. She then called. The call was traced to a payphone outside of a nearby bar. I still wonder, was this just a dumb Halloween prank gone too far? Or was it a potential break-in? And God knows what else waiting to happen.
I don't know if you heard that, but that was a good click in my neck. Alright, so I'm just gonna stop this here real quickly because we have to go somewhere. I'm gonna go to the bar so I can ask someone about a few posters. And then when I get back, I'll come back to the rest of that. How's that sound? Is that good? I'll probably eat this behind the scenes because this is getting ridiculous. And it's getting a bit black here, so. If you enjoyed this part 1 video, I'm getting really tired of doing part 1 and 2 videos, hit the like button, subscribe, and share. If you did not, I don't really care. I will see you in part 2. Wham, bam, sham.